Thanks, Nick. It took 10 days, but all the votes are finally counted in Wisconsin's contentious Supreme Court race.
Incumbent David Prosser is the winner by a margin of just over 7,300 votes. We have team coverage tonight from Kent Wainscott and Abe Lubetkin, who covered the candidates on election night. Kent, the votes are counted, but they may have to be counted again.
Yeah, for now, the official canvas numbers, the final canvas numbers, are posted on the Government Accountability Board's website, but David Prosser's margin of victory is less than 0.5%. That means Joanne Kloppenburg will not have to pay for a recount if she requests one. But that wasn't determined until the final vote canvass was completed just a few hours ago. Now, our 12 News cameras were there this afternoon as Milwaukee County election officials tabulated the final numbers in the state's last remaining county canvass. Those totals were signed, certified, and reported to the Government Accountability Board in Madison. But this race may be far from over. It's up to the Kloppenburg campaign to request a recount. If that happens, the GAB's director told me that the county election officials will now face a new set of deadlines.
Supposed to complete it within 14 days. Realistically, the larger counties will probably take longer. You know, if we all start on the same day, right after the week after Easter, you know, a lot of the counties will be done very quickly. But the larger counties, you know, because we're looking at every ballot. I mean, right now, what you look at is the official returns to do the canvass, make sure that those numbers match up. But when we do a recount, it is an examination of every ballot.
The Kloppenburg campaign has until Wednesday at 5 o'clock to request a recount. The process then could begin the following Monday. But because of the close margin, the Government Accountability Board has been working since the day after the election to prepare counties for the possibility of a recount.
Thanks, Ken. And we are getting reaction from both the Prosser and Kloppenburg campaigns.
12 News' Abe Lubetkin is in Madison working on that side of the story. He's taking a quick break to join us over the phone with an update. Abe.
Right, Kathy. And right now, the Kloppenburg campaign is the focus because it is their decision at this point whether or not they want to request that recount. With the margin between the two candidates, less than 0.5%, as Kent mentioned, there would be no filing fee for a recount. Still, the Kloppenburg campaign at this point is not saying whether they plan to pursue that option. They have, as you heard, until Wednesday evening to decide. And this evening, they say they are deciding what to do. They released a statement which reads in part, quote, "We will review the information available to us and carefully weigh the options." Now, the Prosser campaign says this is the victory that they wanted, and they say it's what they've been waiting for since right after election night.
We're comfortable with 7,300 votes. It was a highly contested race, competitive right down to the last moment. Quite frankly, I'm not all that surprised by the results, but it does provide the victory.
Now, if the Kloppenburg campaign asks for a recount, while they will not have to pay a filing fee, they will have to pay their own legal fees. And even though they will be the ones requesting the recount, the Prosser campaign will also need its own recount lawyers. So they are continuing to prepare, we're told, just in case. But at this point, to be clear, the Kloppenburg campaign has not yet said whether or not they're going to request that recount. Live in Madison, Abe Lubetkin, WISN 12 News.
And Abe is